somebody did something wrong, he pays for it. Why should I pay for somebody else's sin? And how come another person's sacrifice will make me free from this sin?
Okay, what if God is so holy, because he's holy, right?
Yes, he's perfect, holy. Yes,
that
he's perfect.
One sin is worthy of hell. Because that's what we believe. So one sin, one lie, because it doesn't just, one sin messes everything up. It's kind of like the timing in an engine. As soon as the timing is off even a little, the entire engine will start to fall apart, right? Same with us. As soon as...
I'm trying to understand you.
Do you guys believe in the cross of Jesus Christ? Because you know the cross of Jesus Christ makes particular claims on our life. If Jesus really died for our sin, it means that he's worthy of our life and worthy of us living for him.
Right there in that house is the White House where the president resides. You could argue that he's the most powerful man in the world. But really, the most powerful man in the world, the most powerful person in the world is Jesus Christ. He's the name above every name. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He's in the business of transforming hearts and minds. You know, Christianity isn't a message of condemnation, it's a message of liberation. Who wants to be liberated from sin? Who wants to be liberated from the devil? The worst type of slavery that we could have is the slavery that you don't even realize that you're experiencing.
So that we could be forgiven, so that we could be made righteous, so that we could be made holy. That's the good news. The good news is that God loves us and died for our sins. The bad news is that God has to judge sin. But if we repent of our sins, if we put our faith in Jesus, if we turn from sin and turn to God, we can be transformed, we can be renewed, we can be forgiven, we can be made righteous. The good news is that Jesus Christ is real. He is alive and he died on the cross for our sins. If we open up our heart to him, if we open up our lives to him, he can transform us.
There's only one thing that can take away our shame. There's only one thing that can take away our guilt. That's only Jesus Christ. It's only the love of God that can satisfy our hearts. Nothing else in this world can satisfy. You can go to drugs. You can go to sex. You can go to materialism. You can even be the president of the world. You can be the president of the United States. Who knows? But that's not going to satisfy your heart. The only thing that can satisfy our heart is Jesus Christ.
What up?
Here in DC with
DC Living,
and he's about to head to work. I'm about to head to the Capitol for a persecuted church conference. We just went to a men's Bible study at someone's house this morning, and yeah, praise God.
It was awesome.
Beautiful day out in DC. Sunny day out here. Got any good words?
God is good. We're going to have a blast in D.C. when David's here, man. God's going to do incredible things. He's going to save lives. Souls are going to be won over.
Amen. We're going to see the Holy Spirit move in power, and we're going to see lives transformed with the gospel, touched by God's love. And yeah, I'm excited.
Him, Muhammad wasn't like him. Jesus was God in the flesh, and he died on the cross for our sins. The Bible says that we have a problem. Our problem is that we have a sinful nature. We sin. We do things that God commands us not to do. And God being holy and just, he has to judge sin. But the good news is that God in his love took the judgment upon himself in the person of Jesus Christ. That if we would open up our hearts, if we would humble ourselves and believe in him, believe the gospel, he would come in and set us free. He would set us free from the consequences of our sins. He set us free from the punishment of our sins. Because on the cross, Jesus Christ took the punishment.
Shit. Jesus Christ claims, yes. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one can come to God except through Jesus.
Yes.
We often think that we'll be able to do it through our good works, through religion, through going to church. That doesn't get us right with God. The only thing that gets us right with God is that Jesus Christ, 2,000 years ago, took this punishment, took the sin that we deserve upon himself, so that we could be forgiven. So we could be forgiven. There's only one name under heaven by which we can be saved, and that's the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in John 14:6, it says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to God except through me. I would challenge everybody here, hearing my voice, what are you putting your trust in? When you die, which is what everybody hears in this life, they fear death, what is your trust going to be in? What is your foundation? If your foundation is anything other than Jesus Christ, you're in trouble. The Bible says that the devil seeks to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus says, I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Is there anybody here that's tired of having the devil rob from them? Tired of having the devil destroy? Tired of rejecting God? Jesus Christ has an abundant life for you, but you have to come to him in humility. You have to repent of your sin. You have to be willing to admit that you need God. That you need God. That you're not your own God. Thank you.